Need any Elton John. We're live. Steven went to TT, and I'm going to go in a minute. He just calls me early in the morning. I have to be at a soccer game at 9, so that only gives us 2.5 hours. But I'm Debi here with you on a very early Saturday morning. Wake up with Wake and Bake with Debi and Joe Spreaker. And I have something really funny to show y'all later when Steve comes back so I can leave. Good morning and welcome to a very early Wake and Bake. I hate those. That reminds me of Todd Morris, those cheap things like that. Steve is here. He's just not here right now, but I am here with you right now. So maybe I will put something on that we can listen to while I go and find Steve. He's here in my house with me. I don't know where he went. He's probably somewhere stealing stuff. Steve, don't be stealing all my stuff. Come back. Don't steal my stuff. Let's do Hey You Out There. That's too depressing. Let's do my intro. This sounds just like me if you were going to describe me. Here comes my intro, and I'm with Steve Rush. So everybody shut up, sit down, and be quiet.
and ponies.
Hey, Ralph, are you hot over there in your booth?
My booth smells like pee.
Wait a minute, I gotta turn your booth on, Ralph. Shut up for a second.
Well, then why ask me questions? If my booth smells like urine, I'm gonna talk.
I've only let 3 cars in since the day started over there.
Oh, my God. I didn't realize we were in New York.
Did you see that crash? I couldn't believe it. Yeah.
I think 26 people died.
The fat man landed in my booth and got on my lunch. Hold on just a second. Hold on. Hello, sir. That's $3, not in quarters, please. Give me the money or just go make a U-turn and go back down the
make a U-turn.
You don't have a sticker, sir. The sticker expired in 2012. No, I'm not talking about 2112. Look, sir, either go through or not. Here comes a horn. Wait. Beep, beep.
That's a horn, Steve.
What the fuck?
It's one of those air horns.
I
got it for when I go out and walk Gunner. If somebody tries to murder me, I'll just put a horn real loud. I swear to God, I did, Steve. And I told Vic, and he goes, all that's going to do is scare Gunner.
It's gonna make you safer.
I thought.
Why? Well, how?
I don't know. It just says right here. It just says
I'm defenseless.
It says extreme air horn. You dare me to blow this motherfucker right now? Watch.
No, don't. There's people that are.
No, it gets loud as piss.
My brother works on the railroad for Amtrak, so he has those. And on New Year's, he goes out and he just blasts 2 of them. And alarms all around the neighborhood go off. So, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Hold on just a second. Frida, I'm going to go to lunch. All right. Watch the booth. I'm going to lunch.
Oh, I love that.
I already got you out of your booth.
Are we still in boots? Are we still in the booth?
Wait a minute. Here comes a train. That sounds like a dead bird. Here. Welcome to Morning Wake and Bake. I am, of course, Debbie with
Steve Rush.
Hey, we're rushing down the freeway. We're checking them out. Yeah. And we are live. Today is April. It's the 9 April 2522.
.com. Absolutely. And what you said times 2.
What'd you say?
What we're doing right now, I think this is not a first, because we've done this before, but I think it's a good idea. It's just like we were talking, and now it's happening. So we're like, let's do a show, all right? Well, no thought, no process. Let's do it. So here we are.
Let's give us a mic check. You ready?
All right. I think it's a good idea. It's just like we were talking, and now it's happening. So we're like, let's do a show. All right. Well, no thought, no process. Let's do it. So here we are.
Let's give us a mic check. We sound superb.
God, you know, if I sound any better, I'd want to do myself.
If you were any, I'm drawing a blank on that joke. If I were any, if I was any better, I'd be twins.
If I was any better, I wouldn't have a right to be.
Now,
that
here's
doesn't
what
make any sense at all.
That was really stupid, too. All right, hold on. Stop. All right, now here we go. What kind of crap is that to level against a guy? I mean, even if they're not there now, trust me, if you build it, they will come, okay? So here's what we're going to do, Steve. Here's what I'm thinking.
Talk me through this problem.
I'm thinking real hard. What I was thinking is we could walk some people through, some of the newbies out there.
All right.
And we would, BTG abducted me, cum slinger. Anyway. I don't even care. I don't want to care. I don't want to care about it. Okay.
Nothing says quality like that.
Oh, shit. We've got some news to discuss. No, it was, we were going to talk about some of the older shows that we did together, right?
I think that would be interesting. I think a lot of people had this false perception that this is something kind of new. It's not.
Fresh.
This is like almost 10 years.
Here's one that dates back to nothing. It just, there's no date there right here.
Oh, then it could be 1802, right?
It could be, but they didn't have electricity then. So wait a minute, hold on.
Shh, don't tell people that.
Oh, here we come. Watch out, boy. She'll chew you up.
That's what happens when you play Hall & Oates.
Psychic readings.
You just eat men.
You know what? The other day, I was listening to a show that you and I were on, and you go, Geddy Lee is slapping that bass. And you just made me laugh so freaking hard, I was losing my shit laughing. I don't remember what show it was. We were acting stupid. I was going to, as you can see, I'm in a menagerie of shows here. It's like I'm drowning in this.
A menagerie montage. Listen, the craziness was about me and you was like people think that they need to like do this whole like 24-day event to make a show. It isn't that way. I think it's naturally. I think it becomes life, and it becomes normal and becomes funny if it's not faked and baked. And like we're waking and baking, but we're really not. But you know what I mean? It's nice when it's real.
It really is. It's nice when it's fresh. Does that sound any different? Fresh?
Whatever. Use your words. I'll use mine. Whatever. I'm from Chicago. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I know. I'm just trying to look at all this stuff. It never stops. Look, it just goes on forever and ever and ever. It never goes away. Look at all this stuff.
Me and Deb were looking at some of the she found. Should
a hard
I say
drive.
This or no?
It's an
Can I say this?
No, yeah, it's an external hard drive right
it's,
there.
It's not Davy Jones. It's just me asking you this because I know Davy Jones always needs his attorney, which he's going to be on in a minute because he's in the background. He's
waiting. He really?
He's so excited to be part of this.
Excellent.
Because he wakes and bakes every day. And I'm just saying, like me and Deb we're literally like those are shows.
I know
that we've done together or she's done throughout the years. It's fucking amazing that after all that time, it's still number one or within the top five always. And
well, that says a lot for you and a lot for me. You know, that's stick togetherness. And a lot of people have fallen off the wayside when they were trying to be friends and stuff.
Yeah.
Seriously.
But I think that shows legitimacy. I think that shows it was true, it was genuine, and we were having a good time. And you can't fake that. If you fake it, it becomes very plastic, and people see that. And there's people like the Jew, One Angry Jew, that try to be very vicious and angry every single second of his life. And it becomes very fake and contrived. And nobody wants that. Because if you do want it, how long do you want it? It becomes very, very dull, very, very quick.
Now hold on just 1 second. Everybody wait.
All right.
You said a bad word, and you know what your punishment must be.
I don't care. I was willing to do it. I took my chances.
We have to actually force. Why am I putting Scott? We have to force. We have to force our listeners. And like I said, there may not be any there live, but this will be more like a podcast. They'll come later once they see it on the website. Once they all wake up and get out of jail and get their cars all started. So here's our punishment for saying the one angry bad word. We have to listen to like the first intro of this. It's the hardcore punishment.
Oh.
Concert does a spake. It's fake, what? Here we go.
Yeah.
for. Yeah. All right. That's for saying the name that you said earlier, Steve. I'm sorry.
I will never do that again.
Look at those twins there. Look at they're 14. Anyway, so yeah, welcome to the show. This is Good Morning. This is Wake and Bake.
With Debbie and Rush. And what we're going to do for you is we're going to make your day better because you're going to start with a smile. Right, Deb?
Absolutely. And you know what we always have to do the morning of Wake and Bake? Everybody get out and get ready to take a... Don't you get crazy with me. Don't you know I'm local? Hits from the bomb. Hits from the bomb. Pack it, whack it, fire it up, come along. I don't know the lyrics, but I think there's one with the lyrics. I think there's one with the lyrics here. Pack it, whack it. Well, here's another one that's even better. We'll do this one.
Who needs lyrics when you're doing that? Seriously.
Yeah, we should do this one now. Rolling that up. Is like Mr. Midnight Movie right there. Yeah. Okay. La da 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 la da 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 la 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 la. I was gonna go to bed a little while ago, and then I got high. Well, we should do this karaoke. What are those chickens there for? We can do the news, too.
I think that we should talk about chickens.
I feel sorry for chickens. They always get killed, you know, because people eat them and stuff. It's really sad.
Could I ask you a question?
Si, senor. What's up?
Do you like chicken?
I really don't eat anything. Oh. I really don't eat anything. What the
Debbie's invisible.
Now we're going to freestyle. Do you want to freestyle it, Blaine?
Oh, God.
Are you up? Roll another blunt, man. Yeah, cool. Shit, motherfucker. Shit. La la.
Then I got high, motherfucker. I was gonna get up and find a broom, but then I got high. My room is still messed up, and I know why.
Why, man?
Ouch! Cause I got high. Cause I got high. Cause I got high. I was gonna go to class, then I got high. I see, what are you doing, buddy? I cheated, could have passed, but I got high. This song sucks dick, and I know why.
Why, man?
That's too loud, you fucker. Don't scream. Why, man?
Go to the next one.
Okay. We were gonna do a show, and Steve got high. So he called me up, and he said, hey, let's get high. I said, wait a minute, I gotta sell some dope. And you know
why,
what?
Man?
Stop that. It hurts. It scares me.
Because I got high. Because I got high.
This is good.
I gotta go to court because I got... Stop screaming in my ear. I was gonna pay my child support. Then I got high. They took my whole paycheck. Hey, wait a minute.
Why, man?
Shut up. That scares me every time they do that. Ouch.
Because you're tweaking.
Shut up, tweaking,
don't talk motherfucker.
To me right now. Where did. I deleted the baby's recording? No, I didn't. Undo track.
Never. What'd you do? What
this
happened?
This is Tickle Tootie's La La Love. He got. Wait a minute. What did I do? Wait a minute. Oh, I know where it's at. I think. Did I fuck up something sacred?
I have no idea. You know what? You're like in a different time world warp than I'm in.
The baby came over with. Here it is.
Listen. Weed?
No, the baby, the tiny boy came over today. And
okay.
He was, I'm sorry, this is Blaine. Hold on, let me get Debi back. Debi!
Yeah, that's the confusing part.
Debi.
What's up?
Deb, can you please pick up?
I'm here. Steve, Tinker Toy came over today and, is it still today? Last night?
No.
Yesterday.
Well, it was yesterday.
Comes over yesterday. He sits down, and I was trying to talk to Heather, so he wanted to play with my my voice alternator thingy, and you got to hear what all he said. Listen to this. It's really cute.
Oh, yeah.
Boopy ba ba ba. His voice is
real low, like a demon.
That's him.
Okay.
You can hear me and Heather in the background going, "Well, how are you doing today, Heather?"
Hope you stroke. What else, new?
So, are you changing my name?
So you can hear me and Heather talking in the background, and whenever his voice changes, mine and Heather's voice changes too. Isn't that funny?
Yeah.
Pretty funny stuff. So anyway, moving on.
Well, you know, every kid wants a wake and bake, so this is his first opportunity, and it happened. So.
Now, we did a show, I did a show, you did a show with us a couple of weeks ago, or Saturday, the third day of, the second day, yeah.
April, yeah.
The second day of April, we deleted it.
And I would like to know how the week becomes part of this.
I don't know. I swear to God, I have no idea. But it's back up. It's back up on the website. So we'll push that out. I'll push that out later on and get everybody on that thing. And but we did some of it. If you wanted to play some of it right now, because remember, I didn't ever go let Gunner out. Wink, wink.
Right. Gotcha.
You want me to play some of this?
Sure.
Let's
and then
do.
In 1991, I went to my first Rush concert, and that was the Presto Tour.
This will be a little
91.
Tease.
And
right,
I've been in love with them ever
right
since.
Back, Steve,
I mean, there's
okay?
no comparison.
Right.
I mean, there's other musicians out there, and we could debate all day long who the best guitarist is and who the best drummer is and who the best lyricist is, but they are fantastic, and they will always have my loyalty.
And it's a brand loyalty. I think it's something very, very special. If you feel the way I do, and it sounds like you're very adamant about it, you know, once you have something really good in your life, you don't let it go. And
that's.
And Rush has always kind of like been there musically and melodically and lyrically. You know, Neil has written down some lyrics that have been pretty, you know, powerful.
Right.
And you know, it's the soundtrack to my life. And that's what true Rush fans usually say, that this music is a soundtrack of my life. You go back to 2112, 40 years ago. You know, you go back to Fly By Night 42 years ago. This shit is still relevant today. It's still ahead of today.
If you don't understand Neil's lyrics, go back and read Ayn Rand. Go back and read Ernest Hemingway.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Go read The Fountainhead and you'll get it.
Yes. So when he had the tragedy in his family and he went on that motorcycle pilgrimage.
Yeah,
and
50,000 miles.
Yes.
He drove on a motorcycle, guys. For those of you who are listening, 50,000
miles. Ghost Rider, and I read the book Ghost Rider. It's amazing.
Yes. Yes.
You know, yep. He loses his wife to cancer. He loses his daughter to a car crash. What do you do?
Right.
Do you kill yourself like a coward? No. He got on his bike and he rode. And the reason why he did that, he said, I did that. It's a simple reason. He says, because I know that a child, when it's most calm is when it's in his car seat and you're driving. He said, so I thought that momentum and that movement would calm me and soothe me somehow. And I know that sounds very generic and blah, 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 but it's true. So he used his own logic
Yeah.
To fix himself.
But you're talking about... Yeah.
Sorry, I'm done.
You're talking about a guy who grew up in Toronto.
I think we have a bad connection, Deb. No?
What's that? What was that?
I'm just checking. Are I think it's Skype.
Yeah, it'll smooth out in a minute. It's probably somebody that's fucking with us, and you know probably who it is. So let's just ignore it and keep going. Go ahead.
You know, he grew up his dad was a dealer, I think, and he grew up doing auto parts, you know, in his dad's dealership. Yeah. And he grew up listening to music and just being kind of his own geeky kid in high school, learning the drums. He evolved, and when that happened to him, when he lost his daughter in the car accident, and then 6 months later his wife gets cancer, and she had pretty much given up. I don't want to be critical, but she pretty much gave up. I mean, at that point, she took
it. It was terminal. It was terminal, though. Yeah. She knew that, yeah. And yeah, right. Yeah.
And you know, he reinvented himself. And not to say that he became religious or he became anything like that, but he truly reinvented himself to save himself. And if I had this discussion on Facebook the other day, are you on Facebook, Steve?
Yes, I am.
I'll maybe Debbie can share some stuff so we can connect on Facebook. But I was talking to some Rush fans on Facebook, and they were talking about how they were disappointed in the R40 tour, the DVD, the Blu-ray. And they just said that Getty's voice is not what it used to be, and Neil's drumming isn't what it used to be. And you know, these guys are 60 years old. And I wrote in there and I said,
I'm back. And so are we with Steve Rush.
We are. We're back. And that was... a clip from a show that we did last Saturday. So if you're doing the math, that was a little bit ago. Actually, technically, it was exactly 7 days ago. But Rod's a really, really good guy.
Yeah. Did Rod ever tell you what he did for a living?
Me and Rod will not talk about that, as you will not talk about Rod's.
Rod, I'm just asking you. I would never say it on the air.
Yeah, I do.
Cool beans,
so,
huh?
I mean, we're both in positions that people would never fucking believe. I just think it's odd that...
Steve's in the Secret Service.
I own the... I'm Donald Trump's father. I own every motherfucking thing. The water you drink, the words you sing, they're mine. Pay me back, bitches.
You wrote the songs that I just found $200 cash. I just found $200 cash.
How?
I did.
Did I forward it to you? What happened?
No, it was laying under a box on my desk. I was like, wow, where'd that go? Where'd that come from?
You found $200 cash.
Yes, swear to God, I'll show me on my webcam. There's a cigar box.
I believe you. Because
I have a cigar box that I put stuff in. And look, there's 20, 40, 60, 80, 1, 20, 40, 60, 80, 2. No. It's my son gave it to me like about a week ago, and I just thought maybe somebody took it or something. I was like, oh, well, so much for that money. But
well, there you go.
There we go, Jesse Bo.
Hey, now, listen.
What, Pastor Slav?
I think there's... Let's do this. I think we should, if you don't mind, because you're on the marquee. This is your show. And I'll always respect that, and I always did. Let's give people a little transition on how this show, between you and I, Steve and Deb, started almost. And we looked for some archives from the very first call, and we couldn't find them because, man, you're talking years ago. But I think it'd be interesting for the listener to know that this isn't something that is a fly by night or just something that just kind of happened.
All right.
It's something that's kind of special, and
then let's go way back, Steve, back to the days when you and I had just begun the first days that we met, which were a long time ago, weren't they?
Yes.
They were a long time ago. They were really a long time.
How many are we? I'm thinking like.
I don't almost know.
Nearing 10 years of the same two people tolerating each other in a respectable way, and sometimes not respectable. I would love to find the fights too. I would love to find them, man. That would be great. But Debi has 5 gazillion files, so.
Yeah, I have 500,000 and plus some more, I think, after that. See, right. It won't search the time machine, and I hate it for that. It just searches just the computer, and it's so weird. Let me see. You're just going to have to help me out here. What is it doing? It's gone cray-cray. Okay.
Well, I don't know what it's doing.
I wish I could search the time machine, but you can. That's really a drag. Now, it says
you think, that... You'd think that it would, right?
You would think that it would search the time machine.
Yeah.
Maybe since I have it open, it'll search it. Let's try that. Let's see if it'll search the time machine if I put in 1, 2, 3. But see, it disappears. It runs away. Oh, wait, the time machine. Look, hello, good morning. Okay, now we search
it. Morning, and that's funny because it is morning.
Good morning, sunshine.
By the way, for anybody who's listening to this later on in the day, it is actually 6:06 Mountain Time. So it actually is really, really early morning, and we're doing this for real.
Seven past the hour. Look, it says on the time machine, nothing. Time machine backups. And I searched it under that name.
You broke the whole internet. You suck.
Oh, well, we'll just have to do this another way. We'll just have to look on the internet. I'll just look at and find it because that's the way we do things around here. We do things correctly. Look at it going crazy. All right. Now, we're not sure. Here's what we're going to do. Since we can't go in any sort of order, we'll just have to randomly pick out shows that we did together, that, and we'll just give them the dates and just show people how long we've been doing this together and stay best friends.
Sounds good. What else could I say? That sounds good because I think that there's me and Deb, prior to this, going on air, we're looking at all these shows and like, God, there's so many freaking shows with Steve and Deb.
I know, it's unbelievable.
And I was like blown away. I'm like, God, there's so many. And she's like, that's the most person I've ever done shows with is you. So I'm like, let's do a show and let's talk about this. And she's like, yeah, let's do it. Let's wake and bake
with audio from Big Spone Sex.
Oh my God, play that.
No, I don't know what that is. Oh my God, play that.
Debi, please.
No, I get in trouble. I get in trouble.
I'm going to hang up.
Let's see.
Please, sex files.
No. You.com is.
I'd love to.
Let me see. Hold on.
Fucking Vix.
We were looking at these old videos of me, and they were, ow, and they were so funny. They were horrible. They were horrible. Okay, let's see what's going on.
What about the audio? Remember, you probably already have some set up, so I'm being a dick. Remember when you're playing these audio clips throughout the years of these files that spanned? You have to keep people understand. Like it wasn't like weeks. It was like years. It was spanning. It's kind of cool to be with somebody that you care about that much and be buddies with and best friends with for that long. So what do you have?
I'm just looking here. There's so much. It just goes on forever. It really does.
Let me talk about me then. I was born a white child.
To a black sharecropper?
In Chicago.
What are internet whore bags?
slut, cum buckets, and
Aug's dropping microphone. Wait, what is this? This looks old. This is from 2011. It says, Augs dropping microphone. Oh, this ought to be funny. Wait, let me see.
Anything with Augs is never good.
Well, we'll say Rush dropping microphone. How about that?
No, I'd rather be Augs because at that time I was nuts. Go.
Come on, please. Where are you, play? Where's the little hold play? On.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
No, hold on for 1 second. Hold on 1 second, please. Get the microphone. That'll cost me $1,000.
Me and Steve sometimes weren't always in the best of moods. You said you were having some things built. That's when you were having that studio built, right after the crash of 39, when your wife...
1964.
When your wife divorced you, or you got divorced, it was horrible.
Yeah, I was building a new studio. That's funny. God, how do you remember that fucking shit? God, I don't even want to remember it. But, I was building a new studio, and I had... I said, well, I'm going to put like 10 grand in this shit. And if you hear by the quality of the mic at that time, you got to go back, you know, a few, eight, 10 years.
That was
good quality. So.
You remember that drop? Check the chat room. Anyway, that was funny. You want to hear that again? I cut yours off. Here's Augs drops the mic. Oh, you know what? This is so funny. This cracked me and picked up earlier. John Brand sent me a file that was called, he goes, Debbie, I found original EVPs from the Amityville house. I said, no.
Really?
I said, are you kidding me? And he goes, yeah, here it is, baby doll. I'll see you tomorrow. Here's the link. Here's the MP3. He was always messing with me. And here's what it was. He was always doing that shit to me. Always.
Well,
he loved me.
You were susceptible to that because you let it happen.
I know. He said that I was Lucy. No, he was Lucy holding the football, and I was Charlie Brown. Shut up. He used to say that I was Charlie. He goes, you fall for it every time.
It's so true, though.
I know. I used to fall for it.
Swear to God.
John Brand was a friend of mine from Australia. And,
yeah.
You know, he's not with us anymore. Did I ever tell you that?
Yes, I know that. And you know, not somebody I always got along with, but certainly a funny fucking character who could be anybody you want it to be.
What is Rush loaded? Hogs loaded.
Oh, that sounds like it can't.
I think it's Steve's all back. Wait.
Steve's all back.
Steve's all back.
Okay, now I'm going to set this up. In 2011, Steve fell off the show one night because he was wasted. We've all been drunk. I've got drunk stories about me. I can tell you that forever. Steve's loaded as fuck. And he falls off the show, and he calls back in, and he goes, Steve's all back. And then he just starts going, we just got shit of it. Weren't you on bars that night, too? Didn't you have taken a bar or something? Anyway, here is...
I never did that, by the way.
Here is Steve's all back, and it's really funny.
Steve's all back.
Steve's all back.
What's up, Debbie? How you doing?
I'm doing great. What's up with you, Steve?
I'm fine, hon. How are you? Sure, good. And I'm just checking some stages, and there you are.
What do you mean you're checking stages?
We did the show, and where we're not, we did not, and then I did the show with like four other people, so I want to clock those guys
out. I'm not as thick as you drunk I am, Ossifer. Steve, are you there?
I've never heard that before.
You've never heard this before?
I
Oh my God.
My mother's life, I've never heard that before.
It's great. Lots, watch. I go, what do you mean you're checking safes? And you can tell I was pissed off. What do you mean?
What the fuck am I talking about?
What do you mean you're checking safes? See, when I used to get really, really tired when I was homeschooling, Stephen, listen to me. It would be so late at night, and he'd go, Mommy, read to me, or, you know, whatever. And I would sit there, and I'd just be dozing off, and all of a sudden I'd go, well, you know, the other day when we were playing soccer, we went to Red Lobsters, and he'd go, Mom, I go, what? He goes, what were you saying? And I would just start talking bergibity, you know, just crazy. But it's funny because I go, what do you mean you're checking stages? Like, oh, fuck, you know, what is this one?
And I'm just checking some stages, and they are.
What do you mean you're checking stages?
I was scared to have. Oh, we have a call coming in from somebody.
Wow.
I can't add you to the call, though, beautiful people. You have to get off your group call. You have to get off your group. Will you want me to embarrass myself?
No. Please.
You want to hear embarrassing. You should hear me chimp out one time. I mean, and you're on the call with me, Steve. You're on the call, and I'm chimping bad. I mean, bad. Okay.
I did the show, and then I did the show with like four other people, so I kind of clocked those guys out. And
what the fuck?
Starting new is fresh.
Oh my God, whoever you thought it. It's craziness. No one would ever think that way.
Hey, are you okay?
Fuck, that hurt my throat. Wait a minute.
This is the worst I've ever done in my life.
I love you, Steve.
Epically sad.
Oh, I just burnt my lungs with my vape because I forced a cough out. I was laughing so hard. You go, ugh, and I go, Steve, are you okay?
I know.
That's 100% definite. That every word you said was important in that.
Yeah, hit me in that.
So that's the end of that. Now,
hummina. Yeah, that's worse than honeymooners could ever be.
Oh, it's cute.
But see, you have to do this, people. If you make mistakes, play that. That shows that you're real.
Walk right into it. It's not bad.
There you go, girl.
And tip your hat to the waitress as you walk in and just say, here I am. I'm bold enough to say, look, I made an absolute idiot out of myself the other day. But you always came back, and that's what I loved about you. You could take a hit and keep coming, you know?
Well, you know, I think I never, ever listened to any of those shows that we did, those hundreds of shows that we did together. I never listened to those. Because I was so embarrassed in my own mind that I said, I made an ass of myself.
Well, you were going through a hard time, Steve.
Yeah, the divorces and business losses and all this other stuff. And then I'm like, I want to listen to something that I really respect and things that I enjoy. And it didn't happen back then. Like back then, I swear to God, we'd do a show.
That was season three is when you got divorced from the little blonde bitch that I couldn't stand. The little gold digger.
Hot. What a nice little ass.
She was hot, but she was a gold digger. She was a gold digging bitch.
And she got all the money in the world. She walked away with a fortune.
She was a gold digger. All right. Moving right along. Now, Steve and I Steven was always really busy because he was this photographer that everybody in the freaking world had booked, and he was always working, so I only got him on Saturday nights during season three, but on Saturday nights, we would do what we called a music show, and it was so fun, and there's one right here from the year 2010. Here is Saturday Night Music, Saturday Night Whatever.
I believe that was written by Willie Nelson, because Willie Nelson wrote Everything in the Whole World. But it was actually done by Hank Williams in the beginning, along the original.
This is November of 2010. Look, Steve, 1/21 of 2010. It says with Steve Rush Music Madness.
Here's Hank Williams' original version.
Well, I do what
Bad.
Oh my gosh.
What song is that? That's a version. This is by somebody on South Park. Listen. Like Sade. And how many of you are familiar with the singer Sade? Have you ever heard of her, Jake? Or
why
Steve?
My hands in the air, I'm saying yes.
Do what?
Sade was a very sensual singer.
I can't believe I had you on with Jake. I'm surprised y'all didn't kill each other.
Yeah, well, it came close.
Do you remember the show we did where, let's see, I'm just looking, there's so
we, believe it or not, me, you, and Jake did a lot of shows together. Actually, there's probably, I'm going to think at least 20, and that's being modest, that me, you, and Jake Jake never listened to this. And
no.
A lot of people will be like, they agree. Never wanted me on the show with you.
Here's another one from August of that same year, which was season 3. This is Steve and I, a show about music.
Poison. Kind of love. It's real gross. I'm like, get away from me. Because all she does is she just, it's like, ugh. It's just so gross.
We must be talking about Foo Foo. No, I'm joking.
Debi, the only way that she's going to get better is by listening to you.
She's already failed at everything. She's failed at Hollywood. She's failed at radio. She's failed at everything. The only thing she can do is she can... .com. It says, I noticed lately that my ears are ringing a lot. I can hear the birds chirping outside.
Out of nothing at all. Every day.
Incredibly...
sad.
It's a beautiful song, but it's very sad. It's a very sad song, if you think about it in words.
Suicide is bullshit. Suicide is ridiculous. I can't... I don't know. I don't have very mixed emotions about suicide. Some people don't like my opinions on suicide because I think it's stupid. I think it's ridiculous. And I think that people that do it are very selfish people that aren't thinking right. And they actually do it to try to get back at people. It's like, I'll get you! I'll end my life! I'm like, what? What kind of philosophy is that? You'll get me by ending your life? That's kind of stupid. I mean, I'll still be here having a good time, and you'll be 6 feet...
Shut up, Debi. We're Steve. Wait a minute. We're trying to find some more here. My grandpa telling of a hanging that he went to. Wow.
I remember that last little piece, though, because I remember you going raging. You were so pissed off about people, you know, taking their own lives over silliness.
And, oh, my God, I was mad. Not that one. There's one show, and I don't remember where it was.
Wait. I'm going to finish. You were mad for like a month about that. You were so pissed off about that. And I respect you so much for just standing up and just saying it.
Wonder what Og's number one is. It says right here.
If it's Og's.
Funny how? I mean, what's funny about that?
Tommy, no, you got it all wrong.
Oh, Anthony. He's a big boy. He knows what he said. What'd you say?
You're right.
Funny how?
I'm not saying it wasn't. I'm saying who wasn't.
I mean.
Oh, Ralph O'Rama did that. What does this say? Wags Babble. This is stuff that Ralph O'Rama would do he would send me all the time.
But I'm saying it seems as have word you. That's all it seemed like. It word you. So I was just telling you that's what they do. So nothing to be afraid of.
Oh, Wags. I thought that was Og. Okay, sorry, wrong person. Sorry. Let's see. There's so many things on here. Let's see.
I saw it, folks. There are a million freaking files to look through. So
it's really
she's trying
amazing.
To find something that has something to do with the content of this show between me and her. And God, there's so many things.
It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. Look at all of this. It just goes on forever. What are these things?
I'm scared to death of you, you grain-fed country girl. You'll kill me.
Oh, those are drops. That's when you were around. Let me see what these drops all say. Let me open every one of these. Hold on. Let me do a global open. And we'll hit open. Open. Here we go.
Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Put that insult in, then run. Run, run, run.
Maybe toxic or something would get...
Oh, wait a minute. I fucked up. Date added. We're doing this live on the air, so y'all can all blow me, okay?
That's
hard to do. All right, let's see. I think they started like, where did it start at? Here they are. They're right here. We'll start these. Here's some drops that Victor used to do these.
Get you really fucked up where you couldn't think for a minute.
Okay, now why did it go to that? That's really dumb. Go back. Oh, here they are. Wait a minute. They were right here.
Look at me. I'm getting there. I'm getting to where I'm believing I am not going to cast my pearls amongst the swine anymore. Let me give you a little secret, Ralph. Grow a set of balls, buddy. Go to a tip jar. Do something. Grow a set of...
Welcome to the program, Bullet Guy 37.
Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's... Let me give you a little secret. I would not put up with a guy that's pussy. I'm scared to death of you. I wouldn't put up. The ones that flap their mouths all the time, those are the idiots that flap their mouths. Yeah, that was after you took your pill and went night-night. I'm scared to death of you. You got brain.
Steve's all back.
So here we go. Without further ado, here is my show from May of 2011.
Hello, friends. Let's...
Look, I'm just going down the list. Look. Where'd you go, Steve? Damn it! Hold on. Stop it. I lost Steve. Hold on. Come back, Steve. Where'd you go? What happened to you?
Steve's all back.
Steve's all back.
I thought that would be a funny bit. I'm sorry. I had to do it. I just fucking had to do it.
Somebody wants to be added to our call.
Oh, please. And then some.
Now, you won't understand him very well, but...
I know Peter very well.
I love Peter.
He's a great guy. I love this guy.
I do,
Peter,
too.
How you doing, buddy?
Hey, Peter.
Hi. Could you just hang on? How you doing?
Good. We'll hang on. Hey, there you are. What's going on, man? He's on webcam. What's up? What's going on over in Scotland?
Yeah. Please inform us.
Well, it's a nice sunny day, but it's pissing the rain as usual, you know.
Just go, yeah, well, you know. Yeah, I know. We have a little problem going on.
Could I ask Polly B in here? Is that okay, yeah?
Yeah, bring Polly B in.
Let me see if I can get him here.
We have a problem with one of the Spreaker hosts. It's kind of being ugly to me and these guys, and it's unwarranted. We don't know what's wrong.
Well, then in that case, we drop it really quick. But I think if they're fair, we let them be fair. Right?
Well, now, you're talking about a crazy son of a bitch. He's involved in the IRA, so he takes care of business. I'm joking, of course.
Yeah, but, you know, at the end of the day, respect is respect, so.
He's hiding his identity.
Yeah, I saw that.
It's a nice headset you have on.
Yeah, that's a nice set. What kind of headphones you have on?
Amazon special.
They look impressive compared to mine. So, but
Polly B didn't pick up for some reason. So,
it was on a minute ago there. I tried to drag him in like that. Where did I start? Debi Scott Radio Network.
Hey, we're on the air, by the way. We're on the air. We're on the air. Okay.
That's good. That's even better.
Okay, so you tell them what's going on. I got pulled in, but tell them what's going on.
Right. A few weeks ago, things was happening, you know, and Grandpa Ali got banned for talking about his wife. And the other day, I was banned. Paulie B went into the chat room, was banned. So I went into the chat room last night, and I said, well, I'm going to sit back and let this all happen, right? So I said, right, when did you... Van Polly. I don't need to answer that. I said, yes, you do. I said, I'm going to sit back and let you ban everybody that's associated with the Celtic Hub Radio just for the fun of it. I said, who the fuck do you think you are? You know what I mean? So I fucking, I let it rip. I went in there all guns blazing last night and they banned me. You know, but all the lies and all the things that she's making up, I think she's going to take over Spreaker. And you know, not just me, it was Grandpa Al, it was Fluffy, you know, ripped these guys to shreds for doing nothing, you know, but you learn something besides it, you know. And the things that she's making up about them behind their backs, she won't say to them to their face. You know, oh, by the way, Grandpa, blah, 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 you know. But when she wouldn't say it to him. She'll talk about them behind her back. Well, if I've got something to say, let's say if I had anything to say to you, Deb, I would say to your face. Same with you, Steve, I would say to you, there's no way I'm going to go behind somebody's back. Because what's the point? If I went and talked to you behind your back, oh, right. Why did you say that before? You see what I mean? You know? She's... She even did a show the other night, Debbie, and I have to be honest with you, when I listened to it, I said, God, I said, that's Debbie Daly's been country. You know, and I'm going, wait, yeah, that's no Debbie Daly.
You know? Yeah, that's a good point, because you don't, you kind of don't piss where you're going to eat. And the fact is like, you know, this is a great show, and her show is a great show. And the people that come here and make messes don't come back. You know what I mean? So.
Oh, I most definitely. But see, when you try to copy somebody else's show, this doesn't work because it's not your own style. You know what I mean? I do my style. You probably do yours. Debbie has her own style. At least if I was to go and say copy, say your show that you do, it wouldn't work out too great because it's not my style. And... You know what I mean? I don't know what problem I'd like to be conscious. Over the last couple of weeks, it's, people can't even go into their chat room. Which, if I went, fuck, oh, banned. You know, if I went out and said, oh, you bitch, you know, banned. Everybody was getting banned, you know. I don't know, you know. We've gave her hundreds of chances, you know, since she came on Speaker, what, 2.5, 3 years ago. Oh, it's been murder, you know. It's okay for a couple of weeks, then bang, somebody's did this or said this or went this. You know what I mean? It's, you know, we've got other things to bother about in Debi Scots Radio Network.
Peter, there are a million views that you can have on other people and views that you have in your own life, that things that don't work or work. You know what I mean? So I think that for you to make those decisions are very important. You know? I mean, if it doesn't work for you, don't do it.
Yeah.
And the reason why me and Debi are doing this show right now is because it worked. After 9 years, we're still doing the same thing, you know, and today was kind of a celebration of that. And I think you give a great example of things that can go wrong. Things don't always go right. Things are bad sometimes, right?
Yeah, most definitely. But see, when I started on here, what, 2011, 2012, you know, I didn't honestly think I would still be sitting here today. Like, honestly, I have to be honest with you, I don't. Like, I just came on it because I got a link. You know, don't get me wrong, I've been on Speaker, I was under Peter Boy Radio, I was under TFOK Europe, I was under Galactic One Radio, and I went back to where it all started, the Celtic Hub Radio. I've been off for the last 6 months, but when I came back after 6 months...
Have you always been her friend, Peter?
Say again?
Have you always been her friend?
No, only for the last... Well, I've had a few fallouts with, to be quite honest, big times, like... You know, but she's been okay, I suppose, but when she starts accusing you of things, that's the bottom line. Like, you know, I wouldn't accuse you of something, or I wouldn't accuse
accusing me, Debi Daly, of something?
No, she'd always accuse me.
Oh,
of something,
okay,
you know?
I'm sorry.
she would talk about people behind their backs, and it all came to a crunch last Tuesday when she accused me of hacking her computer. Hacking your computer. I said, I'm in Scotland. I said, you're in Florida or Hollywood or wherever. I says, you think I've not done nothing better today? I said, if I was going to hack a computer, I would hack somebody I had cash. You know?
Peter, Steve again, I'll say this, I like you. I've spoken to you numerous times. I don't know if you remember any of that, but on multiple calls, you've been there, and you've always been respectful. Yeah. And if you notice my voice and my tone, I've always been respectful to you too. I think you're a nice guy.
Yeah.
I think that it's time for you to make choices that may be better for you, because at the end of the day, the only thing that you have is your respect and the way you hit that pillow without guilt. And that sounds really profound and deep, but I mean that.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. See, when two or 3 years ago, like I said, I was pulling the reins in, but I don't claim to be number one.
Hello?
Hello?
Who is this? What number did I call?
Hello? This is the New York City Police Department, Precinct 6. Precinct 6, we have a warrant for your arrest.
Let me see your hands.
I'm coming to get you.
Paul, what's up, brother?
What's up? This is Steve. How you doing, buddy?
Now, let me tell y'all something. How you doing, brother? Let me tell you what I think happened. When she first hit the scene, she played the role of a South Louisiana drunk with her husband behind her, and she'd be like, oh, boy, I'm here to party, you know? And once you lay that down, you never can really rise above that. And nobody takes her serious as a podcaster anymore. I know she does her. I know she does her music shows, but to lash out at people like you, some of the best people on this network, which are like Peter, Polly B, even us, you know, me lashing out at me. Now, there was one time, I will give you this. There was one time last fall that I had a really bad 2 or 3 days. I mean, everybody was being horrible in my chat room. So I just started banning everybody that came in my chat room. Everybody. I banned everybody. And she was, anybody that was in there laughing along with the hate that was going on, there was a little hate fest going on, they got banned. And everybody was unbanned the next day. And that gets held over my, is that something that she holds over my head all the time?
I don't know if she does, I just remember that one time when she called you so, her and John were drunk off their ass.
Well, I just think that, hey, Peter, over your right shoulder, is that some of that that has a little dark, is that cologne? Yeah, that one. Look back there behind you. There's a shelf with some toiletries. Is that some of that old, no, not that one. Look, isn't he cute? Go left. There's one with one of those, one left. It's got like a brown top. Yeah, right there. What is that? No, further. No. Further. My dad used to have this cologne that had like this dark wooden knob on the top of it. It was like woodsy scented or something. Anyway. Yeah. Let me see what that is. What is that? Is it cologne? Oh, never mind then. Okay. You're so funny. But, I mean, I think once you know, they say you never get a second chance to make a first impression. Nice.
Moonshine.
Very. No way.
Moonshine.
Real moonshine? Oh, my. Did you make it? Oh, okay. Shh, never mind. But I think once you never get a second. Damn. You never get a second chance to make a first impression. And I just think that, you know, she'll never live down what she did on Guy Shea's show. You know, just all that.
Oh, definitely. Me and Paul were just talking about that 10 minutes ago. About what he did say. That. And I have to be honest, you, guys, she would bury her. And I'm...
Well, she has no reason to attack me. I've never done anything to that woman. And all I've ever done is be nice to her, period. That's all I've ever done is be nice to her.
But as you say, when you first come on, you try and make an impression, right? And let's say, you know, your first show or your first two or three shows, if you haven't made an impression and you try and make it to be something you're not, when you're found out, it's not going to go doing too well for your listeners and everything like that, you know? Let's say, I don't know, how would I put it? I just don't bother what people think about me, you know, as long as I do my shows. It's, I suppose I'll tell you, you know, we did hundreds of shows where it's just me and him in the show. But ever since she came on about 2 years ago, all hell just broke loose, like. And, you know, that's just my opinion, like.
Did she ban you out of her chat room, too?
Oh, yes. I went in last night and I says, why did you ban Polly B? I don't need to answer that. Oh, sorry, I'll say again. That was John.
Yeah, you do. J-O-N. I mean...
Right, I says, I need an answer. So you've been talking to Polly B? I says, yeah, I've been talking to Polly B. I says, I want an answer. Why did you ban me? I don't need to answer you. Right? So I went in there all guns blazing. I says, look, he's one of my DJs. Grandpa, I was one of my DJs. Fluffy's one of my DJs. You banned every one of them. I said, I want the answer. I said, I'm not going to sit back and let you just rip the guts out of these guys, you know, when they've done nothing. I said, so I want a fucking answer, you know. Never got an answer. So the band, she blocked me. Good riddance. That's the way I look at it, you know.
Yeah. I mean,
Spreaker
is a
fucking your show, Debbie.
Uh-huh. I'm sorry, you know, what did you say?
If I came to your show and I said if I came to your show and just say you banned Polly B and I came and asked you a question, I said, well, baby, why did you ban him? What did they do? Whatever, right?
I would tell you.
An answer, but no, you know, he wouldn't have given you a straight answer anyway.
Who's doing the banning? Is it her or John?
It's her, probably.
I think it's John.
How do you know that?
Because when I was in the chat room last, just the impression I get, the two of them are on two different computers. But I think John's the one that says, see, if you say, are you in the chat room, Debbie?
Mm-hmm.
Or Steve? And you go, fuck. Oh, damn. Oops. What have I said? You know? Right?
Right.
We'll ban you automatically. Or if you put something that's not appropriate... It's not appropriate in the chat room. They'll take that off as well. Anything that's not appropriate, like Grandpa Al has fun at his wife's expense, that's not appropriate. So that gets banned and it gets removed from the chat room. You know, even though it's just a bit of fun and laugh, it's nothing serious, you know. But Grandpa Al's always been like that, as you know. but that's her, you know. You can't, you have to be all clean and kosher. Is that the word I'm looking for? All clean and kosher. You can't say
hold on, Peter, for 1 second. For first thing, you're right. I think sometimes we have to be too politically correct. We have to be so perfect and we have to say these fucking things that we would never say in real life. And the people that we're saying to, we would never say that way to them. So we're being too politically correct because that's America's way. I mean, that's just the way we do it. Things, unfortunately.
Not me. I walk around the grocery stores and look at the women and go, come at me, bro.
I could see Debbie doing that.
I'm joking.
Come at me, bro. But in all seriousness.
What's it?
Go ahead.
But I tell you, Sunday, if I seen you walking around Walmart, I would fall to my knees.
Most of them do. I mean, what do you mean? I could lie. It's a curse. No, I'm just saying, you know, like Steve says, Steve, do you remember whenever I had somebody doing all my handling my chat room and it was Josh Peterson?
Yeah, of course.
Do you remember the problems that he caused me by banning everybody out of that chat room?
Well, what happened was, it, for those who don't know, Debi had a show that was so ginormous. That's a real word, by the way, ginormous. That there were so many people calling in and trying to be part of it that she needed to get somebody, and several people she tried throughout that history to screen people. And then all of a sudden, these people were nuts. And they started banning everything. So if you said Debi Daly is a queen, you're banned for no reason. It was just because they had the control. And that's what happens in all of media. That's what happens in all of politics. People with control lose it.
I see where you're coming from.
Yeah, and I had to...
What I was going to say there, let's say, we're on internet radio. We're not on CBS or Fox or any of your top media radio shows. So right. If you want to go, fuck. You go, fuck. You know what I mean? But Debi Scott thinks that's what she is. All clean and kosher and, oh, no... Watch your ABCs, I don't even go past B. Oh, I know, A was for ass, B was for butt. But anyway, I never go past C. So she, every time you go on, watch your P's and Q's. I say, well, I didn't get past ABC. You know, so that's what you get. You go on a chat, watch your P's and Q's, watch what you're saying.
People have to realize that Spreaker is first and foremost a social network. It's a place where people gather. It's not, amen. You know, I mean, I know that there's some people on here that consider themselves professional podcasters or radio stars, but it's really a social, well, we got a lot of weird sounds going on here.
Yeah.
I demand perfect sound. What is that cutting? Something's chopping on and off or something. What is that? Anyway, I and for everybody to sit in ninja mode, in stealth mode, and watch your chat room like that, and then just attacks. Okay, guys, we got some really loud noise. What is that?
That's coming from Paulie.
It is?
Me?
Yeah, it is. Unfortunately, and Paulie, I'm sorry, man. I'm looking at the screen, and I can see your screen popping whenever that happens. So, it might just be a bad connection. So, not being a dick, dude. I'm telling you, that's. I'm looking at the screen. I see clean audio, and then I see you, and all of a sudden I see a pop up in the red. So,
Steve, you put me in the red. Damn it.
Right. You know, give me turn your audio down a little bit. Do you have the ability to take your audio down a little bit?
That's dead.
I mean, your audio sounds great. I'm just saying that there's some misconnection there that's causing the disruption a little bit. So, all right, Debi, I apologize. Go ahead.
That's all right, Steve.
All right, brother.
Well, you are pissing Blaine off. He's over there jumping up and down to be on the show because he's going to...
Steve, I'm the producer here. I'll watch the goddamn audio, okay?
All right, you do that.
You failed us, Blaine.
I'm a juggalo and I failed us. Motherfucker. I'll watch. Hold on, Debi. Let me turn the reverb off. Give me the mic. Give me the mic, Tyrone.
Oh, shit. I'm in trouble.
Stop it.
I'm in trouble. I'm in big trouble.
Pookie, do not wake up Ray Ray. I'm on the air with Debi. Now, I wanted to say something. We got dime bags. We got quarter bags. We got eight balls. Whatever y'all need, just let me know.
I love an eight ball right
me,
now.
Me, Pookie, and Ray Ray are here. Debi, don't cut off. Debi, don't. Debi, don't.
Don't you even start that shit. You do not sell drugs on this radio show. Do you understand me? No.
I'm talking about tobacco, Debi. Pookie Bob. Let me tell you. Hey, what happened? Fuck. Matilda, take a long walk on a short fucking pier, and I'm going to slice you with Debi. I'm sorry, Debi. Debi, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
That's it. That's it. I'm sorry. They're in a bad mood. They don't have donuts for the morning, and they're all in bad moods.
What, you didn't give them donuts, Debi?
No, they can go get it on Matilda's bicycle.
I'm on the fucking show, and I didn't get one donut, nothing, one fucking thing. She gave me nothing.
I knew.
That's why I'm pissed at her.
Donuts. Wait till I show you why.
Donuts. So me and Steve were taking a walk down memory lane about our old shows that we used to do, and we were in a dream state. Remember, we were doing a long time ago in the land of Blog Talk Radio. Me and Steve were having fun on our show one day, and suddenly he calls in for a reading. Remember that?
You haven't?
So we're going to rewind and go back a little bit. Stop it. We're going to rewind a little bit and go back. But there's been a first time for everything. Now, I had the pleasure of having Peter on. Okay, here's the bottom line. Hold on. Matilda, stop it. Stop it. Sit down. I see him on closed circuit. Tell him, sit down. Put your pajamas back on.
She's naked? Is she naked?
Yes.
Wait, how does she look?
She's pretty Raquel Welch looking. She's not bad. I'll tell you that.
Nice tits.
I don't know all that stuff. I'm a girl. I don't know.
You see her naked. Tell me.
Let me... Hold on. Matilda?
Steve, let me just tell you this much, bitch.
Oh, my God. Never
mind. I want to send a message out there to the target. Get away, Thaddeus. We're not having relations again. Stop it. Debi, don't cut me off. Okay. Debi Scott, let me tell you something. You're not that you have to be, well, how can I put this? You have to be something great to be just banning everybody out of your fucking chat room, okay? Fuck you, fuck your show, fuck your band, and don't, Debi, don't turn me off.
You're not gonna talk like that to somebody else on Springer.com. That's rude.
Right, that's it.
Give me a break.
Yeah.
Shut up, Steve.
Good point.
Hey, look.
I love you. I love you, though.
I want to sing a song. I was going to go get donuts. Stop it! Let go! And then I got high. And then I got high. And then I got to forget. All right.
I just cut him off. That's like listening to crazy people or some shit, you know? But that's all.
It's like a family reunion.
It's urban survival tactic is all it is. They always fight and shit.
Shut up, Deb.
They always tear everything up.
Don't start laughing. Don't.
Is anybody here? Hold on. Put Tyrone's shoelaces on. Put Tyrone on.
Give me the goddamn. Debi, listen, sweet baby doll love. You're looking good this morning in those shorts I saw you at. Love you, baby. Hey, listen. Is this Polly B I heard? Polly B? Is that you, Bubba? Polly B. Did I lose y'all? The fuck?
Polly B, you're being summoned by one of the greats.
I got some great A bud over here, buddy. Wait, stop. Pookie! Damn it! Let go! I'll kill you!
They're all fighting like crazy over there. Tyrone will police the situation for us, boys and girls, and they'll come back, hopefully, in a little while. It'll be better. But that's, you know, really the bottom line, because I was talking to the boys about this earlier, and I was thinking, you know, I go over to her show the other day because she had a guy that was talking about Martin Luther King, and I was interested, and I just said, hey, who's on the call? Ban. I thought, okay, what are you trying to be, Tyree Sneed? You know what I mean? I feel like I'm talking to myself here.
I'm here. I just...
It's all good, dude. It's all good.
That's what happened to Paul as well. He just went in, hi Debi, banned. Al did a show on her network, and he got banned for the full time.
One more goddamn time. Motherfucker. What do you mean, Marmox? What do you mean we're not muted? Are you fucking kidding me?
Listen. You're done. Alright, for the rest of the show, you're done.
Fuck you, Steve. Come on, I'm 6'8". I weigh 402 pounds. I dare. I fucking dare.
So does my grandmother. And she's dead.
Stop it! Let go! Steve, I'll fucking kill you! Let go of the mark! Debbie's coming over here. God damn it, move! Run, everybody, run!
Busted again, loser. Bye.
They think I'm coming over there because I turned the CRT, the closed circuit television off.
Yeah, they have no idea. That's good. So let me, Peter, hold on for 1 second. Paul, how you doing, buddy?
Hell, you got him scared to talk now.
Paul, please, man, come on. I've always been cool with you for 10 million days. What's up?
Hello?
Oh. Hey, what's up, brother? How you doing, man?
Good. I've been here. I'm getting coffee. That's why you're on mute right now.
I did not have any... all right. Hi. Tell me something.
Ulcer.
Tell me something new.
Tell me something good. Wow, wow. Tell me, baby. Tell me that you love me.
Yeah.
I love you, Debbie.
Debbie, keep dancing like that. Tell me something good. Wow, wow. Pookie.
That's not right, Tyrone. Tyrone, when
Steve,
Debbie
I want to tell you something, motherfucker. I want to tell you something
Tyrone,
right now.
I'll beat
fuck
your
you.
Ass.
Fuck the horse you rode up. God damn it, Pookie, stop it.
Tyrone, I don't want to beat
I'm
your
gonna
ass.
I'm going
to
kill him. I'm
going to
fucking kill Steve. Oh, fucking hands on him.
I finally got somebody to talk, and Tyrone just like, I'm gonna own this shit. Fuck you, Tyrone.
I just cut their mic off on my. But who wants to hear my wake up horn? It's time to wake up here in the Debi Daily Show. Uh oh. You want me to push it full blast? You ready?
No, please.
Oh, my God. Peter's going to kill me. He's asleep. He goes, wake me up 15 minutes before the soccer game. He's going to fucking kill me.
I have news for you. Guess what?
Tell me something good.
The birds outside my window just died.
What'd you say?
The birds outside my window just...
Aw, you killed the birdies?
Because you're no, you did with your sounds
the birdie.
Of being all awesomeness. All right,
I'm
the only person that's gonna talk is.
Go ahead. <Steve. clears throat> There's something wrong with me today. Turn it off, please.
Too many buttons, Deb. Too many buttons.
I'm not doing any of this stuff. I'm not. I'm just over here sitting here. I'm sewing, actually, while we're talking.
I'm sure you are.
I am.
You're sewing your next deception of destruction.
Shaka Khan. Shaka Khan. Shaka Khan. Shaka Khan. Won't you worry? Won't you worry, Shaka Khan?
That song is so huge. Remember that? God.
Oh, yeah. Coming at you. That's right. I'm dancing for Tyrone. Yeah, baby. No kind of feeling inside. No, I'm not turning around. Don't be bothered. Tyrone, stop. You're going to break the house. Surely set your soul on fire.
Debi, I used to date Shaka Khan. Yeah, baby. Let's do this. Yeah, Miss Sam. Oh, fuck, I'm sorry. Pookie, wake up! Debbie's dancing in those shorts. Pookie, get over here. Here we go.
it to me, baby. I'm sorry. I've just gone fucking nuts. I've lost my control of this show. I'm sorry. Something's wrong with me.
You think? You think?
I'm sorry.
You think you lost control? I think you lost control about fucking an hour ago.
I'm a bad mamma jamma.
I know. But I love the... Tell me something good.
I'm a brick house.
There we go. All right, so...
Tyrone's doing all this shit. I'm not doing anything. Tyrone, stop it. God damn it.
Oh, my God. There you go.
Turn it off. Turn it off now.
Okay, well... Listen to me whistle.
Nice.
That is a big house. Wait, wait. Turn it up. God, we're fucking dead. Here she comes.
Hello.
I'm so sorry. Turn it off. Turn it off, Matilda, now.
What's this music?
It's Matilda. They all woke up over there. See, I have a satellite studio that is in the back of the house, but I have them on closed-circuit television.
Right.
And they, you know, Tyrone looks like, did y'all see the Walking the Mile, Walking the Green Mile?
Mm-hmm.
You know the guy, John Coffey, spelt like, not like the drink?
Yeah.
It's John Coffey, but not like the drink. Like the drink, ma'am. And that's what Tyrone looks like. Now, Pookie and Ray Ray weigh about a buck and a half soaking wet. And they're drug dealers. What can I tell you? I hire people out of jail and stuff. I give them a chance.
Good rate.
Yeah. Wow.
I'm
that's
sorry.
Something.
Well, they're good. Mm. And now it's time for the weather brought to us by the good people at Do We Cheat Them and How.
Thank God.
Friday, mostly sunny. Highs in the upper 70s.
Thank you. We'll be back to you. We're going to do that. Here's a little more weather bought for us with the good people at Winer Diner Dicker Than Dunker.
Cloud to ground lightning will be the primary hazard with any storms.
Great. We'll be sure. Woo. Let's go to a soccer game. Party.
Let's play in the field for that one.
Ground to sky. What does it say? Ground to light. Ground to what? Lightning? That sounds pretty scary. Stop making that noise, goddammit, you idiots. Stop making that crazy noise. Is anybody listening to this show right now?
No. Good. No.
I won't delete it.
Don't delete it.
Yeah, Debbie, don't delete it.
Here's the funniest thing. Me and Debbie said, we're doing a show that's going to be like our past. You know, a lot of these shows that we've done, hundreds of shows and video clips, audio clips, and guess what? You guys show up.
Nothing ever fucking works out. All my titles are stupid. It'll say, like, music and lyrics.
Right.
It'll be me and Mr. Midnight Movie fighting like fucking cats and dogs or some shit.
Yeah, right. So this is a complete fail.
No, it's not.
Oh, sorry to ruin your show.
No,
Steve.
No.
you don't. No. I don't mean it like that. I'm saying that.
I know. I'm messing with you, Steve. God.
I know. I got.
Well, let's
got,
stop. How else would you mean? We were doing a fine show until you stupid fucks called in. What the fuck does that
good,
even mean,
good.
Steve?
I'm glad. Fuck up your show, Debbie. How about that?
Ignore him. Ignore. That's very, very rude. I'm sitting here putting on my makeup. Can y'all tell I'm putting on makeup in a mirror because I love staring at myself? I'm very narcissistic.
Yeah, I'm so sad right now. I want to cry, but I can't.
I think I'm going to do a song called The Narcissist. I think I'm going to let y'all talk while I wash my hair real quick in the background. Tell me something good. Wow, wow. Yes,
Debbie. Do me a favor.
Shut the fuck up.
Could you wash your front while you're doing your hair, please?
I need to go
Come
wash
on,
my hair.
Steve.
What?
Debbie's not that kind of woman, all right?
Wait a minute. Here goes a train's going by. Shh, listen to this. Choo-choo.
Oh, God.
I like my horn. I hate y'all, all of y'all.
That's like 1840 sound effect. Paul, how you doing, bud?
Polly B in the chat room. Stop scratching, foo-foo. I'm going to go on mute so I can wash my hair, and I'll be right back, all right, boys?
All right, you wash your hair because there's other people that need attention, all right?
You ain't got no kind of feeling inside. All
right. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. I love you. Bye. Bye. What I've got, we're so... gonna put aside.
Are you doing tornado doggy? What are you doing, you crazy idiot? What are you doing? Gun, gun.
Paul, what's up, brother?
Wake up. What's up? Where's Peter? Peter.
Here I am. Peter's right next to you. Yeah, found you.
Peter, where's the moonshine, man?
We all need that right now.
I had enough moonshine last night. Hey, I thought I was the crazy fuckery speaker, but you guys take the biscuit.
Well, you have to work at this.
My hair, and it's gonna make a lot of noise.
You lie. You're Gunner, not gonna it. Wash your hair.
Gunner Anthony. Gunner, stop rolling around on
the
bed.
That's the only dog with a middle name. Gunner Anthony. What the fuck is that about? I never even called my dog by a first name. I just said, come here.
Nope. Sorry, guys. I forgot to meet the dog.
Yeah.
Debi?
Gunner.
Are y'all going to talk Debbie's or what? Like,
Gunner.
Yeah, we can't have dead air or Debbie's going to be pissed.
Are y'all going to talk or should I put on Shaka Khan? Okay, do something. Go.
Okay, I'm going to dance for you, Debi.
By the way, Paula Chippendale.
Yes, right.
But Debi, I'm naked. Debi, I'm naked and I'm dancing. Woo! Look at my balls.
I walked all the way back over here to say I think it would be more like chip and fail. Just saying, love y'all. Love y'all. Yeah. I'm gonna go wash my hair now, so don't talk to me.
Chip and deal.
That's pretty good. Jeez.
Well, we can't use chip and deal. That's copyright.
She's not a newbie. She gets this. All right, so who wants to get naked and dance?
Steve, you said you were going to do that.
We no, you fucker. We all have to. Everybody takes off their clothes and shut up. Listen to me. Keep your headset on and dance naked. I don't care if there's a cam on or not. You fucking dance naked right now because this is part of the show.
Didn't know you were that way.
I'm not that way. I'm just saying that it's part of the show. Show some respect for Debi. So, all right, my dick's out. Not I shouldn't have said that. I'm sorry.
You shouldn't have said that, Steve.
I apologize. I
hope you've had that. God, that button.
Yeah, there's no buttons for that. All right, let's naked and dance until she's done with her. What's she doing? She's walking her dog.
Yeah, she's walking her dog, man.
Oh, this sucks.
Yeah, you're dancing for nothing.
The fuck?
Oh, you're naked as well.
Yeah.
I am so pissed.
Paul, why do you call me the mascot? Because you fuckers are just cracked. You fuckers are just fucked up. I thought I was fucked up, but you definitely need medication.
I know. I think he needs moonshine, Peter.
Fucking hell, sweaty.
I think that the combination of being naked and taking drugs works. So everybody get naked and just dance in a circle until you fall. And then the last person... The whole time.
And don't be passing out now, Steve.
Do the whole...
I'm close already, though.
Do the whole hands or whole dicks?
Paul, I'm done. I'm gonna fall out. Three turns, I'm done.
Uh-oh.
Ah.
Shouldn't have took too many drugs, Steve. Sorry.
I never did drugs in my life, but you know what? I don't need to because my balls are swinging so hard. It's like hitting sinks and shit. It's bad. It hurts.
Oh, my God. You're going to pass out, Steve. Debbie's not going to be happy if you pass out on her.
Hey, guys. Hey, guys. Whoa. Let me in here.
Yeah,
can
go
imagine
ahead.
Seeing this on Debbie Scott's network? Right. You can imagine us all being on Debbie Scott's radio network just now. We'd all be away. We'd all be completely banned by now.
That's true.
Yeah. Aye. You know, it's like, you know.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so
the thing is,
so Steve,
I feel like I'm the only naked person alive.
You're the only naked person alive.
I'm pissed off at you guys because you said you'd do it and you didn't do it. So,
well, you say, Paul, Peter, you guys. Tell the hub radio. We just make you do whatever and we don't do jack shit for you.
God.
Now, Steve, don't be crying now because I don't want to hear crying now.
I'm upset.
Oh, no. Peter, he's starting to cry, man. What should we do? Just give him some more moonshine.
Yeah, there you
go. Moonshine. Yeah. This show was brought to you by Moonshine Incorporated. This show is sponsored by Moonshine Incorporated.
That's right.
don't let the co-host be upset. Don't let the co-host ever be upset because that's a bad thing. Because I'm crying right now. As Paul completely put out there.
Oh, Steve, why do you want to hear you cry?
I don't want to hear myself cry either because it's a bunch of bullshit. Anyway,
okay, continue.
I think we need to see Debbie naked because I think we're playing this whole fucking game. Like, we're all cool, we're all tough, we're all big badass guys. How about this? How about we want to see Debbie fucking naked? Yeah? After 9 years, after 9 years of approved having her back. I want to see her naked.
Steve, we don't want to pick off Vic now.
I don't give a fuck about Vic.
Oh, man.
Are you kidding me? Vic is my guy. I love Vic. And me and Vic could talk for hours. All right? That's how good me and Vic are. But I'm saying that. Imagine this. Seeing her naked. That would be like a godsend for me. I think. You? No? Maybe not so much? Tell me where you're at. Come on, guys. Come on, beat fucking man up.
How am I fucking it up? How do you even answer your question yet?
Man up. What do you think? I'm thinking Debbie Dale naked, it would be like the ultimate like win.
Oh, aye, most definitely.
Yeah. Okay. So yeah,
as long as she shaves her armpits and nowhere else.
There you go, Peter. I'm agreeing with Peter now.
Paul, what is the? I already heard that.
I'm gonna go get two oranges to eat for breakfast. But I heard that, Peter. You fucked hard. Be nice. Be nice, you guys. I'll be right back. I'm going to go get two oranges.
Paul?
She heard you, but she didn't hear what Steve was saying. Damn.
After years, you kind of avoid people. Paul, what about you, man? Do you want to see her naked?
Oh, yeah, all the way, Steve. Mm-hmm.
No, don't lie, man. Be serious. You're fucking lying.
Peter, tell this guy.
Hey, I thought I was...
I thought I was the only mad bastard, you know. But you guys take the risk. They called me the mad Scot. They called me the mad Scot for the last 11 years. I've always wondered why.
So Paul, do you have a thing for that?
Oh, yeah.
Why? Because you're human?
Yes, everyone's human, Steve.
That's good. See, yeah. That's what I tell people. I'm like, you know what? Why am I attracted to this person? Because, I don't know, I'm human. So, good answer. All right, so now that she's getting naked and getting ready for this big show, what do we talk about?
Okay, but Steve, get the camera going right up to her when she gets in the shower now.
It's shit. I have 15 cameras ready.
All right.
And
I'm out of the shower. I just really had to wash my hair. Who else is on the call now?
Ooh. No one.
Have y'all been entertaining our audience?
No. We're trying to be calm and collected.
Yeah, we didn't give you no dead air, Debi, so you're good.
Well, if it is,
I have orange juice. I have fresh fruit juice running down the front of my blouse.
See?
I'm being weird today. Something's wrong with me. I've gone crazy.
Wait, I'm done.
At least I'll never have rickets, right?
Double what, Steve?
I'll never have rickets. Hey, do y'all know why they always carried rum on ships, like a yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum?
Yeah.
Why?
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 You said yeah. Do you not know why?
Oh, don't tell me I said why.
Because, I'm sorry, I'm eating an orange. They used to carry it on the ships because it didn't go bad. The water would go bad. They didn't have, like, you know, chlorine or anything like that to put in it, like our, like Monsanto does, and in the Illuminati put chlorine in all of our water to kill us. But they would carry rum instead. Do y'all know why pirates wore a patch?
Why is that?
No. Wait, okay. Why?
I bet you think that all pirates had a bad eye, didn't you?
Nope.
Okay. Have you ever been out in the sun? I'm eating an orange. Have you ever been out in the sun on a boat? Right? And you go down, you go down to the bottom of the boat where you go underneath to the little, what's it called?
The bow.
Well, that's the
bow.
Okay. And you can't see for shit because your eyes are like, fuck, it's so, you know, your eyes are so used to that sun that it takes them an hour to adjust to the dark, correct? Well,
yes.
When pirates would go and take over ships and they would go underneath to the down to the bow, they would have one eye that was patched and they would flip it up and they could see perfectly in the dark.
That's kind of interesting. I like that. That's intelligent.
Well, pirates, did you know that pirates were real?
I always thought.
Do what? What'd you say?
I always thought all pirates were blind in one eye.
No. What I'm saying is your eyes have a hard time adjusting from bright to dark. Like, okay, for example, let's say you're out swimming and you go inside. Have you noticed how your eyes take a long time to adjust? You can't really see?
Right.
Yeah.
Well, if one of them's got a patch over it, you just flip the patch up and you can see perfectly. There's no getting used to it. Do you get it now, what I'm trying to say?
Man, I need to be a pirate.
Well, you better go be one, Steve.
Did you know that pirates were arrested and prosecuted in the United States of America as late as 1910 in the United States?
Really?
Yeah, swear to God.
What law would that be? Wouldn't it be 1810 or you said 1910?
No, it wasn't 1810. It was, see, in 1899, my great-grandfather witnessed a hanging. They took all of his, they used to take your kids down to see hangings to make them be good, you know, and obey and say, that's going to happen to you if you're bad. Well, I was doing research on the gentlemen that were hung that day. I say gentlemen, they were axe murderers. And when I did, it took me to a website that was a history of all the murders that occurred in Louisiana, Alabama, Florida, stuff like that. And you wouldn't believe the men that were charged with being a pirate.
Would that be DonaldTrump.com?
No, I left my goddamn glasses in the bathroom. I'll be right back. I just thought that was cool. I mean, pirates, when y'all were little boys, y'all used to pretend you were pirates. Being a pirate is really cool, is what I think, or whatever.
Well, Paul didn't.
Tell me that you love me, yeah.
Right, Paul?
That's right.
I like you, Paul. I like you. You're a good
like
guy.
You too, Steve. Yes, yeah, Steve. So are you, Steve.
You're funny as fuck.
Hello, sunshine.
Steve, get the cameras, man. She's going to the bathroom, man.
Sleepy head.
They're working.
Hold on, I'm trying to get
this on. This is about 1 month you'll see the videos.
I'm back.
Hi. When...
Are y'all talking
Hi,
ugly
Debbie?
Behind my back? Y'all hate my guts.
How?
Now, why would I talk about you like that, Debbie?
Yeah. Damn it.
It's a bit of orange.
I don't. I only want to hold it till I come. I mean, that's not big. That's a good thing.
Come where? No yucky boy talk. This is a girl show. I hate yucky boy talk. I won't even share a bathroom with a man. To this day, after 20 plus years of being married to Victor, I will not share a bathroom with him. I just think boys are yucky.
See now. That part I agree on. Like, well, I've been married. Yeah, I've been married. I've had. I'm sorry, Peter. Go ahead.
You haven't seen the right boy. I'm saying, well, Debbie, if you've never shared a bathroom with your man, you haven't met the right man.
Really?
No.
No, boys have hairy legs and hairy legs, and they're just hairy and they're gross and they stink and they go poop and it's horrible.
I hate to agree with her because
I've never pooped in my life. I have never pooped in my life, Steve. Never, never once have I pooped.
Never. Nope. And you know, you should never have. I have been with girls all over the world, and I swear to God, when they leave the fucking bathroom door open and they're going, I'm like turned off completely, like 100%.
And Mr. Manette, nobody likes for him to poop on him. Sorry, just kidding. Love you. I love you, yeah. Brian.
I'm just saying, like that was, like I've been in Las Vegas where everything happens, right? I've had strippers. I've had, you know, I've taken photos, so you know. And I have all these girls around me, beautiful. They're naked. They're pissing. They're shitting. I don't want to see that. And they're like, come in the bathroom and see my things. I don't want to see that ever, as long as I live.
Steve, I hate to tell you something, but you accidentally said the words, I've been everywhere.
The man that's been everywhere, Hank Snow.
I was toting my pack along the... Shut up, clappers. Along came a semi with a high canvas covered load. If you're going to win a muckamack, me you can ride. So I climbed into the cab and then I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen Steve Rush and where he had been. And I said, hey man, Steve Rush has been everywhere in this land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Crossed the deserts bare, man. I breathed them out in the air, man. Trouble I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. Where have you been, Steve? You know, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Windsor, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Ottawa, Lapua, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tubbergilla, Brunnigilla, Paddigilla, Amagilla, I've been
everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert, bare man. I breathe the mouth of air, man. Travel, I've been my share, man.
What about you, Polly? Where have you been? He's been to up on Cornell, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texarkana, Monterey, Faraday, Sanaday, Tallapoosa, Ching Rock, Rock, Little Rock, Okaloosa, Tennessee, Hennessy, Chicken Boat, Spirit Lake, Grand Lake, Devil's Lake, Crater Lake, Pizza.
I know the one lyric.
I've been everywhere.
Yeah. I've got that one down. The rest of it is like, you know what it sounds like? Sounds like this.
No, it's real like words.
Let me finish. It sounds like a seizure. It's bad.
You mean like a seizure?
I'm grateful that you put me in there, but it sounds like a bad seizure.
You've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tupacola, Record. I never can do Barraquilla and Patadilla.
What the fuck are you made of?
Sugar and spice and all things nice. Now, Polly's been to Boston, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texarkana, Monterey, Faraday, Santa Fe, Tallapoosa, Glen Rock, Black Rock, Little Rock, Okaloosa, Tennessee, Hennessy, Chickabow, Spirit Lake, Grand Lake, Devil's Lake, Crater Lake, Beats Lake. I never forget a lyric as long as I can never live.
You are the best music person I've ever met in my life. And I hate that because we do the same shows together. It's like, fuck, she knows this.
Yeah.
It literally blows me away. My roommate Sandy, my girlfriend Sandy.
Your roommate is
what is she?
You said roommate.
I did.
That's bad.
I use words.
Don't say that.
She is fucking amazing at words. If you say to her a common song like Stairway to Heaven, every single word.
Can she do Life is a Rock but the Radio Railed Me?
I'll bring her on tonight. Sure, tonight.
Debi.
Sir?
Debi.
Sir?
Debi.
Sir?
Sir?
Yes.
Speak words.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
How are you doing? Right. Debi, can you remember that thing I sent you?
Yes.
About
oh my God, that's the funniest.
Unsound lyrics.
Yes, I love that. But here's me doing Life is a Rock. I'm going to find that after this little brief message from Life is a Rock with the radio world me. It's funny as fuck. Baby Bubble and the Stinger Bombs, but Hoople, Rachel, Simmons, Naughty Mac, and Twingy, Vinny, here's my ring, we're going steady, take it easy, take me higher, liar, liar, house on fire, locomoco, pulse, passion, detour, purpose, satisfaction, baby, baby, gotta, gimme, getting harder, Sandy's cooking, Leslie Gore, and Richie Valens in the story, Mahavishnu, Virginia, my conversation, Rama, I'm a Richard Berry, Spectre Berry, Archie's Partners, Nazir, and Shimmy, Shimmy, Coco, Poppin', Fats, 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 Poppin'. That's me singing on SingSnap.com. You can all go there and sing too.
Sick.
You were walking all over that.
That is sick.
You mean sick as in bad?
Yeah.
I gotta turn it up louder. So my DJ told me. Okay, go to the other part, stupid. FM and clicks are clicking while the clock is talking, taking bridge and roll the sound attention, Brenda and the tabulations, Carly Simon, Ivy Holder, Rolling Stones and Cinder Folder, Johnny Cash and Johnny Rivers, can't stop now, I got the shivers, Bungo, Jerry, Peter, Paul and Paula, Mary, Dr. John and Mother, Driver, Dare, Stay and Jack the Ripper, Gotta Go, Sir, Goddess, Walter, Leon, Russell, Give Me Shelter, Miracles and Smoky Places, Like a Jazz and Fender Bass, Special Mom, My Brother, Bam, and Princess, Pick and Chop and Kick it. Go the next one. The next one. Fuck off and die. What was so urgent that you had to talk over my thing?
What the fuck would you do that for?
Because I'm trying to entertain people out there.
God, you're good.
In the listening audience.
You know me, right?
What?
A lot of years. You know that I know bands, right?
Right.
And guess what?
What?
I would do one-tenth what you just did.
Well, it's, you know what they say? There's two kind of people in the world.
What? Don't tell me.
Those that have it.
Don't do it.
Those that don't. That guy that did the Misheard lyrics, was his name Jared?
No, PFK.
I'm PFK.
PFK.com.
Listen to this. This is funny. Now, don't talk over this. That's rude. Rude, rude, rude. Telephone, Vic. Gunner, stop it, you idiot.
When you're singing on a karaoke, you haven't got a clue that those were words. I was singing Take That Back for Good. Wash your back. Wash your back. Wash your back. Want your back? What's this? Want your back? I've been singing Wash Your Back 15 years. It's only when you go on a karaoke and you see lyrics, that's what they're supposed to be singing. You know that song, We Are Family? For years, I thought they were singing, Just Let Me Staple the Vicar. Right? Who's right and who's wrong here? Listen.
All of the people around us, they say, can they be that close? Just let me staple the vicar.
That's what they sing. Just let me staple the vicar. What's all that about?
Just let me staple the vicar.
We're giving love in a femidom.
We're giving love in a femidom. We are family.
You know Duffy, the Welsh songstress, last 3 years I thought that poor cow were begging me for birdseed. Mercy! I thought it was birdseed! I'm on karaoke with it. Birdseed! Birdseed! Mercy!
You can't go on thinking nothing's wrong.
Drive by the cars, beautiful song. They used this on Live Aid. Do you remember? They showed it over this harrowing footage of these starving Ethiopians. If you listen closely, they're actually singing about pork pie. Pork pie! What's it going?
Thinking nothing's wrong.
I pledge money, me. Pork pie! I pledge money. Sick BBC. Can't believe it, can you? You know what I mean? Should have been on here. Apparently, according to Michael, your burgers are the best.
I can hear you best. Your burgers are the best.
Can y'all see him? I've got him on my screen for y'all.
He must have had one of them burger vans. Yeah. Well, they have at Bumpers. Doing steak Canadians and hot dogs. Speaking of hot dogs.
Near, far, wherever you are.
I believe the hot dogs go on.
I believe that the hot dogs
got a bit of rivalry here, Michael. Celine's peddling hot dogs. It's on his patch. Meanwhile, Katie Lang's singing about arseholes. I don't waste my evenings.
What do you-
never born you. I swear to God, born you. Bobby Gentry, Phil, listen.
Gentry catch pneumonia. After you do, he'll never bone you.
Phil, I've sang that at Cow, my mum. That. Every time I think of it, I piss myself.
Every time I think of it, I piss myself.
I do my own choreography, in case you're wondering. I can't believe you kiss your cock at night.
As light as shines, machine, baby, take off my shoes before you let me get in. I can't believe you kiss your cock at night.
Can't even see mine, let alone kiss it. I've got a Rander over the toy shop. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Good night.
Isn't he funny? Isn't that funny?
Hi, good night.
Are y'all still, who's all still with us?
Yes.
I'm here.
I'm still here.
Y'all want to hear Robin Williams talk like Peter real quick when he talks about golf? I'm sorry, Peter. You knew I was going to do this. This is what it's like listening and trying to talk to Peter Boy at Peter Boy Radio. Take a listen. It's funny stuff.
Want a linguistic adventure? Go drinking with a Scotsman. Because you can't fucking understand them before. You land in Scotland and they're going, Tiddle-tiddle, if you like. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, right, you think it, yeah?
Fuck, take it, fuck, like, burn the bullets, that's it, right? Take something you think of it. Sure. Oh, fuck, sure, right? Man, you know the fuck, like, backside, they'll treat your ass on the floor of it, came, eh?
You know, it's true. It's so funny. It's so cute, Steve. Have you ever, are y'all there? Who's with me?
I'm here, Debbie.
I'm here.
Where did Steve go? Steve, where did he go? After you
I think he passed out. I don't know.
No, he was having fun. I have to leave in about 15 minutes, so he should stay with us for the rest of the show here.
Well, contact him. Get him to get moving.
I think you should at least say bye-bye.
Mm-hmm.
He's not answering, I guess. Huh.
Steven.
I don't know where he went.
Steve.
Well, we had been talking. We'd been talking on a Skype call with a lot of different people, like, since about 4 o'clock in the morning, so he's probably tired.
Well, you didn't say bye, Debbie. That's not right.
Oh, I agree. Oh.
Aye, that's just ignorant, not saying goodbye, like.
Maybe he actually passed out. Maybe he hit the floor.
He's probably hit the floor laughing.
Yeah, probably.
That was funny. I like that guy. Pretty funny. I'm sorry I'm putting on my makeup.
I've got a lot of good ones there.
If y'all knew me very well, you would know that every Saturday we have soccer.
Yeah, soccer.
Soccer. And I'm putting on just a little bit of makeup so I don't actually just frighten
soccer
everybody.
Soccer Saturday.
Yeah, soccer Saturday. We have a game today at 9 and at 3, so.
Ah.
Yep. But other than all that, we're just, I can't find, Victor came in here, I don't know where he went. I guess he went back out there to get dressed or something. I don't know. Yeah, so I think the best way to handle the situation with that person is just to say, hey, you ban us out of your show, then F you, right?
Yeah, most definitely. We won't be back.
Well, I'm just going to
give her a helmet and a potato.
In my personal opinion. I'm just saying. What's so funny?
Debi, you didn't hear?
What?
I said I was going to give Debi Scott a potato and a helmet.
I'm sorry. I'm shaking my hair out. My hair is wet. My hair is wet and I'm shaking it out. What are y'all laughing at?
Helmet.
What?
Head.
What did you say? I'm out of the joke, I guess. I don't know what you're talking about.
Debi, are you listening now?
Hey. I'm listening. Debi? I'm listening.
Okay, I'm going to give Debi Scott a helmet and a potato.
Oh, and some mittens?
Yep.
Yeah.
There's some weird people on this platform, I'll tell you that right now. Some really weird people. Crazy people. Oh. Yeah, we were just doing a stupid show. We really weren't doing one that was completely real or whatever. We were just kind of goofing around on the... It was a Skype call that we were just putting on the air, to be honest with you guys. But listen, I got to get to soccer. I got to go get my jeans on and all that stuff. All right? Y'all, hook up with me later on tonight, and we'll do a real show, okay?
Okay.
All right, Peter?
Yeah.
And don't get drunk. Right. Don't get too drunk.
Oh, no, yeah, don't get drunk, Peter, because, you know, Debi doesn't like that.
No, I do. Shut up.
Oh, no. I have a train wreck on her show one time.
Oh, my God. Call Rick. Debi, call her. I went to all the trouble to make him this entire show with a show page. Shut up, I did. I made all this nice shit and everything, and he just didn't do it. He was in the great. Correct, Debi. It was funny. So, did y'all hear my big bill drop?
Mm-hmm.
Listen to it. It's funny. I love it.
Hi, this is Big O 420. You're listening to the Debi Daily Network. Your host, Debi Daily, the one that knows everything about everything. She cannot be told she's wrong. She is the one that knows everything.
Spoken like the intelligent person that you are, Bill.
And everything I just said was a lie.
Bill. Get off my show. Get off.
Well, way down yonder in Louisville, lived a cat named Big Bad Bill. I wants to tell you.
Hi, I'm Peter from Lightning Radio, and I never listen to the Debi Daily Show.
All right, Polly, you're up. Give me a drop, and I'll let you off this call.
Oh, drop? Hey, this is Polly B. This is the Debi Daily Show. Do not go to Debi Scott,
cut,
or you cut, will die.
Cut. We need cut. Boop. Wait a minute, I gotta blow the horn. Places, everybody, places. All right, you're gonna go. Hi, this is Polly B from Shooting the Shit with Polly B and the Fuck You Network. I never, ever listen. Now, Lester took it one step further. He was going, I wouldn't be caught dead listening to the Debi Daily Show. You're gonna tell him you never listen to the Debi Daily Show in three, two, and one. Go.
Hi, this is Polly B from Shooting the Shit. Yeah. I would never listen to this Debi Daily chick. She is bad news.
All right. That's enough. That's too much. What the fuck? And Peter boy. And now we're going to, I'm going to put it on. You'll see. I don't care what they say. I put it on. And Peter boy in 3, 2, and 1.
Hi, this is Peter boy from the Celtic Hub Radio Network. And you definitely won't.
Okay, you fucked that whole thing up. Cut. Okay. Hi, this is Peter Boy of TFLK Radio, and I never listen to the Debi Daily Show. Ready in 3, 2, 1, action.
Hello, this is Peter Boy from the Celtic Hub Radio Network, and I definitely don't listen to the Debi Daily Show.
Really? Well, then screw you. Get off my show. Get off my show, Peter. That's what I started screaming at Bill. I go, then get off my show, Bill. All right, you two crazy guys. I'm going to get ready for soccer, and I will catch you all on the backside, all right?
All right.
Y'all are both adorable. Pray for Steve.
Oh, so are you.
Pray for Steve. All right, bye. This is Debi with you here on Spreaker.com. And we were just having a Skype conversation and decided to put it on the air just to be goofy. So that's all. I'm going to be back on later and listen to the first of this. It's really funny. Steven and I were just out of control. I'll talk to you guys later on. My name is Debi Daly, and I never listen to the Debi Daly Show. Goodbye. We'll be back later.